affecting everyday life. Those things are affecting personal lives and they're affecting international lives. However, if we don't, come on, baby. If we don't keep our eyes focused on the prize bowl, we'll be consumed by all that. Like you said, 2020 is to a bad start. Until it was impressed upon you, you know, go back.
Yeah.
Get some perspective real quick. Yeah. You feel me? Get some proof because it is, bro, it's a cold world, bro. Yeah. You know what I mean? And the tragedies, my thing is this, bro. We serve a God to where, like, before I was a Christian, teacher, chill out. Before I was a Christian, bro, I looked at a bad situation as a bad situation. I didn't know any other way to look at it because bad is bad. Like, a death is a death. A sickness is a sickness. Like, now that I'm a Christian, bro, every situation I get to use for God's goodness and I can wrap it in the love of Christ to where I can teach a lesson in it. I can grow from it. Somebody else can grow from it. So when it comes to the death of Kobe, you know how many people I counseled through that death? Before, I'd be like, bro, I don't know what you're calling me for. I don't know how to counsel you through this. You know what I mean? And even with the coronavirus, bro, understand it's just so much we can do with the circumstances, bro. It's so much hope, so much light that can be shown through circumstances, bro. But if the world focus ain't on God, bro, they gonna look at it as just a tragedy upon tragedy upon tragedy upon tragedy. We look at it as opportunity about opportunity.
Yeah,
exactly. Even if it's a small start like this.
Even if it's a small start like this.
That's the beautiful thing.
I love these humble beginnings.
Sure what I want this video to be. It's pretty documentative. I'm not gonna dive deep into all the obvious things that everybody is aware of about this year, like the coronavirus, Kobe, politics, protests, all of that. It's more of just to show how I've been affected this year. How the people I've surrounded myself with have been affected this year. The things they've accomplished, the things I've accomplished. And how my lifestyle, my life was like amidst everything that's happened. So I don't want to dive too deep into tragedy, but I just want to show from my perspective what life was like this year. Like I said, it's not a documentary, even though it is documentative. It's more of a retrospective. So, first things first. I remember when Kobe died. I was completely dumbfounded. And I'm assuming everybody's reaction was the exact same as this.
And retired a local institution and international icon. The outpouring of the past 96 hours is evidence of his everlasting impact. Whether he played for your team or against it, his allure was unmistakable. The dynamism, the determination, the drive. He won 5 championships with the Lakers. And shortly after unfurling his final fadeaway, earned an Academy Award. He was a storyteller, a mentor, and above all, a father. His 13-year-old daughter, Gianna, was a basketball star in her own right. Join us in tribute to Kobe, Gigi, and all the victims, born throughout the Southland and across the globe. Orange Coast College baseball coach, John Altobelli,
his wife Carrie, and their daughter, Alyssa. Sarah Chester and her daughter, Peyton. Mamba Academy basketball coach, Christina Mauser, and pilot, Ara Zabayan.
As soon as you step outside, you can see the impact that Kobe had on the city. People sharing their art, their talent, either for the spare change of thousands of grieving people, or just to lighten the mood of the city, knowing how much Kobe truly meant to LA, and even the rest of the world. Even with how poorly the year started off, I came across beautiful people who were doing the little things, still trying to make the world a better place amidst what had happened and what was about to go down.
For the last month, me and Brian and Pastor Braden, we just go out there every day. We offered free prayer, free snacks, free water, and free love. And the reason we offer those things, we just like, all right, Lord, what can we afford to give these students that's going to impact them? Mm. Free prayer, bro. Yeah. Like every child, almost every student that asks for prayer, they never ask for prayer for themselves. They always ask for prayer for their grandmom who's sick, their dad who just got out of prison, their brother who going through heroin, their mom who they ain't seen in 3 weeks. Like those are the things that they deal with. They take those things to school, and then they gotta balance education and having friendships, and then they gotta walk that long walk back home knowing that those are the things they gotta deal with. So I'm like, man, we about to offer them free prayer. We about to offer them free water, because it get kind of cold out here and kind of hot out here, man, when they walking these miles home. And then we gonna offer them a free healthy snack. And then we gonna offer them free love. We gonna wrap our arms around them, bro. We gonna be genuine. And the point is, man, it's a lot of neighborhoods that got some big, dope, pretty-looking churches, bro. And the church wants you to come to the church in order for them to talk to you. Like, we not about that life. Like, we going to go out in front of the church, in a community where the schools is at, and we going to meet the kids where they at and let them know, man, the stuff that you can't talk to your mom about or you intimidated to talk to your dad about, holler at me about it. The stuff that you going through at school that I know you going through at school that you can't talk to nobody else and you don't think they understand, believe me, bro, I've been there. I understand it. And then guess what? They leave with a smile on their face, and then they can't wait till next Wednesday to see us in front of this church, bro. It's a beautiful thing that God has privileged us to do, man. So we, it's a beautiful responsibility that I am honored to be blessed with, man.
To impact lives, to he said, if you love me, feed my sheep. So our job is to go out and feed the sheep, to go out and to minister, to go out and to bring hope, you know, to be that river of hope into different neighborhoods, into different communities, into different hearts and lives. And that's what we're about, you know.
And 2 weeks later, I watched Fury humble Wilder.
Jesus.
Fuck yeah.
Also, luckily for me, I was able to make it to one last show before everything went bad. Shortly after that, I went canvassing with my homie Connor for Bernie Sanders, until, unfortunately, he dropped out. But again, Connor is one of those people who was doing the little things, still spreading light whenever he can, you know? It wasn't much longer until the first COVID case hit the United States, which was actually when I saw things begin to worsen. And as the virus became viral, both in cases and on the media, toilet paper became scarce out of all things, and there were mass food shortages, which is crazy to see for the first time living in America. It inevitably turned into a global pandemic, which called for lockdown.
Get out of my room.
That's Sasha, huh?
I said, hello. What's your name? Really like to know about you. Too bad I stopped at hello.
It's higher. Hello. I can't do it unless hello. I'm on. Unless I can't sing
too
properly.
Too bad I stopped at
when off the melody.
Like that?
Yeah, it's higher.
Aside from the more sentimental moments I had in quarantine, like watching my little sister learn how to play ukulele, the family and I had a lot of time on our hands, which we used to fix up my mom's new house. With the help of my abuelo, of course. Turning this backyard into this.
What do you mean?
But
what?
You're messy as hell.
No, what?
Nothing.
And as everybody ages every single year, that means I did too. So somewhere down the line, still stuck in quarantine, I turned 19.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Mr. President George. What? Happy birthday to you.
Oh, no, fix your hat.
You guys ready?
It's so fluffy.
small. Angel, will you record it? Your dog.
I got snacks.
She was like, okay, what's his favorite cookies? No, Twizzlers are strawberries.
No, from my family.
From Christmas.
This is from
Mom's.
These are also from the band. But I
want to. Hello, others. What are you doing, Maya?
I'm writing.
I will.
I'm embarrassed that I'm writing the
what are you doing?
You motherfucker, happy birthday, man. Just wanted to call you, say I love you, and I keep forgetting that you're basically 10 and you're young as fuck. I'm like, god dang, you just turned 19. Nah, you have the oldest, brightest, beautiful soul I've ever met, and I am incredibly honored and indebted to God and the universe for placing him, or placing you in my life. So I just hope you have a beautiful day, man. I know you're probably busy with family, chilling and everything, but I hope you're safe, doing well. You're on my mind a lot, man. So I hope you're doing well, and if you ever need someone, I'm here. If not, it's all good. I'm still here thinking about you, stalking you. So it's all good, man. It works out. I'm fucking around. But, yeah, man, you don't have to call me back. Just want to say I love you and hope everything's well, man. Happy birthday to many, 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 many more, man. Always be there for you, brothers. Peace.
And finally, after months of staying indoors, when the entire world apparently thought the pandemic was settling down, we were finally able to make an escape.
This is joy, this is summer. Keep alive. Stay alive. Got your medal on. We're alone. Taking sweet thoughts, taking time. Gosh, Jackson. That's a pretty fucking fast year flew by.
Get grim.
That's a pretty long third gear in this car. Gliding on the fly. Gear run across. Killer headlights. Pretty fucking underneath moonlight now.
What up, Graham?
Pretty fucking.
What's up, bro?
Sunrise and sun comes the morning, hunting us with beams. Souls the same as far as it used to be. It begins to blur, we get older.
Blur.
Summer's not as long as it used to be. Every day counts like crazy.
We really met up with him, of course, out of nowhere.
Wanna get soaked? Wanna film a tape on a speedboat? We smell a Californication. Everything grows in the Congo. Everything grows.
You guys have your own cameraman now.
They grow whole ass hippo.
Shoulder carried away.
stronger. Congo is down.
Smoke.
In comes the morning.
Bro, the beach is so blue. The waves are like just
yeah,
popping.
Yeah, you missed it.
I had it. The bioluminescent waves are actually there. I thought they went away.
No, they're still there.
No, they're still here. Hella bright.
Glowing.
Man, I want to come.
It was nice, Jose. It was not, I'm not even gonna lie. It was
too bad you had to listen to your mom.
What's up, Chia?
What up?
The cameras, what's up?
What'd you say? We're just chilling. We're just chilling. We have a cat out here, too.
What's up, Theo?
I actually forgot one of the big reasons we went to the beach was to see the bioluminescent waves, but we were 2 weeks late anyway. And also, I had the honor of being a part of one of my best friend's greatest accomplishments.
My booth, I'm falling back on the wishes to practice gratitude. My life aligns when I change my attitude.
People's lives for the better. I want to help people. I want to get my homies jobs. I want to like provide for people. I want to do all this shit. But at the end of the day, I just want them to like my music.
Yo, Connor, this is a message for you. I believe this album was very pivotal. It was such a stepping stone for you, your music career, your life, and mine as well. And it was such an honor to be a part of it, so I thank you. I've literally watched you grow as an artist. It's been amazing, from this thing just being an idea to something that people can enjoy, something that I enjoy myself on a weekly, if not daily basis. So be proud of what you made, man. You deserve it. As your dad says, it's slapping. Peace and love.
I remember when George Floyd died. The first time I saw his murder video, I was so angry that my body was literally shaking. I was trembling. I had so much adrenaline. I was so angry because I couldn't do anything about it. I couldn't save him. I couldn't help him. And there was nothing I could do. I just remember laying in bed all night. I remember watching snaps of the riots and the protests and the looters, not only in Minneapolis, but all across the nation, all over the nation. I I was enraged. I was enraged, but I couldn't do anything about it because I've personally been affected by, anyone who knows me really well has known that I've personally been affected by the police force, because that's what they are. They're a force. They're not a service. They're not protectors.
Anyway, this is a collection of the snaps that I watched that night.
Man, that is some heat.
Woo! Fuck.
That's somebody apartment building, or is that they car on fire over there?
Oh my God.
It's going up. They setting fires to cars and shit, y'all. It's going up on the... Oh, shit.
Tyler, get in the car. Get in the car now, boy.
Niggas gonna start acting the fool trying to get what they want out here. Let me get the fuck on out of here with my babies.
There's people that have been living here. Like, you cannot be doing this. You cannot be doing this. Seriously.
This is a fucking response! Simple as that!
Bro said that's for all the tree breath, y'all. You got your little six pack, you good? That nigga ran in here, almost slipped on the glass. What? Got it, it's gone. Yo, this wild, bro.
The whole six right there.
Whoa. Colt 45, nigga, you got a whole liquor store? You want Colt 45?
It's, do not take no refrigerator stuff, cause it's been not with power. All this shit is melting. Oh shit, got some gold, yeah. About to give me some gold, yeah.
Wow.
Y'all better back up before he shoots y'all.
They done swooped around the ATM. They ain't take it, though. They ain't know how to do it.
For so long, not feeling helpless, just feeling so useless. I got up and I decided to go make a stand.
Hey,
The protesters started damaging property.
If you want to see the full extent of what happened that night from the people's perspective, I'll leave a link to it right here. What was really dope is that while I was in jail, I found out that my homie Connor was actually protesting too. Unfortunately, that night didn't end up too well for him and his brother either. When me and Connor got out, we linked up and went to a few more protests together. Thing is, after sharing stories of our experiences, we were able to piece something together that is very interesting and really, really worth looking into. Now, this next segment is very long, I understand that, so if you want to skip it, that's totally fine. Just skip ahead to this time slot right here. Just keep in mind that everything we talked about and discussed, as you're going to hear in this audio clip, is all speculation.
They don't give a fuck. They're taking after everywhere. That shit is going to kill other people.
I memorized it all night. I was repeating it in my head, bro. I was like, this is so important. I need to fucking know this license plate like the back of my hand. I still remember it. Like, I can't believe God put me here right now. Like, that shit, I was talking about it all day. We need to find this license plate. And God fucking put me right next to the license plate. And then again! This is the video. Oh, fuck, dude. Look, alright, look. That's the car. Gray fucking Dodge Charger, right? Look at that shit. That's the fucking car, bro. That's no coincidence. That's it.
No license plate on the front.
That one doesn't have a license plate.
It's it, bro! That's the fucking car! Bro, we have to take these people down.
We gotta play our cards right and fucking not end up in jail again.
I know.
Jail was not that bad, but like, it's not fun at all. Yo, that shit was crazy. Did you see? I got out of the car and she said, "Didn't you just get out of jail?" She was like, "Welcome back."
That's awesome.
We need footage of it trying to hit people where the license plate is visible. That's essential. If we don't find somebody with footage of that, then how are we gonna prove that this cop car is also the one hitting people?
We won't be able to prove it. We need to get the fucking video.
Even if it's the exact same model and color.
Yeah.
What you said about it being at the exact locations. Where protests are happening, where cops are, it has to be.
The cops were trying to murder protesters. That's what is happening. That is attempted murder in every way. That's where this shit gets dangerous. Because do you know what makes a cop car a cop car? If all of its license plate is just numbers. That has numbers and letters, but it's with the cops. Meaning it's a cop driving their own car. Trying to kill protesters, but clipping up with their bros. That is so fucking illegal. Let's go get these people. They're talking about scary people driving up there.
Drive us down that street because the Dodge Charger that tried to murder protesters is parked right up there with the police, and I need to get footage of the license plate. Can you drive us up there? Okay. Yeah, let's go.
Oh shit.
You saw me win, man.
Thank you so much.
Show us where.
You're gonna drive up this street, make a U-turn, and drive.
Actually, can you make a U-turn at the next light and then come down?
Do it on my street, okay? U-turn on my street.
Let me know where.
Yo, make sure you're hitting
the street.
So this Dodge Charger that's with the cops right now is the same Dodge Charger that attempted to hit the protesters in the intersection in Fontana. It's a cop.
All right, right
a cop tried
cop?
To hit them. Yeah, look, that's right the
here?
Charger right there. Same license.
Recording slow-mo.
You turn
right here, right? All right,
no, go up one more, babe.
One more?
Do you want them to U-turn right here or go up one more?
Go up one more.
Go up one more, Sweetie.
So that we could come down and we could get the back end.
Yeah. This charger right here.
Right, it's the gray one.
Slow down.
Stop.
All right, keep going.
Got it.
I think I got it.
Got it. We definitely got it. Get the fuck out. Go by the protesters.
Yo, that charger just dipped.
Are you dead ass? The fucking charger left?
Holy shit.
It's not behind us, is it?
Here's protesters. We just drove by the Dodge Charger. Dodge Charger that tried to hit protesters in Fontana is parked right up the street, right over there. Protesters, y'all see it?
Text yourself,
okay? Black Lives Matter protesters, right there. This is Rancho Cucamonga. That was Rancho Cucamonga PD up there. That was a police officer in a personal car. There were letters and numbers on the license plate parked right here. Just two nights ago, maybe three nights ago, at a Fontana Black Lives Matter protest, a Dodge Charger, the same Dodge Charger, tried to run over protesters. Here are the protesters.
Oh, shit.
I thought that's
wrong. I don't know.
That's
just.
Fuck the police!
Fuck the police!
Fuck the police!
Fuck the police!
Black Lives Matter!
Black Lives Matter!
Who's got the power?
Fuck everybody who's covering this shit!
That's why
we're all
right.
Are you serious? This is a peaceful protest! If you feel the cover this shit on the news, cover it right!
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right.
We will not be silenced anymore!
Period.
No more silence!
Period.
No more silence!
Everything.
People signs at the helicopter right there!
We have had enough!
Let them
if
know!
If we are being caught on the news, I want these motherfuckers to know it's the people who have the power!
We got the power!
We kneel for peace. They kneel on necks. We kneel for peace.
They kneel on neck.
Take a fucking knee right now. What? They kneel for peace.
Thank you for that. Thank
they
you
kneel on our necks. They want to kill us on broad television. Fuck those motherfuckers. We kneel for peace. Right.
They kneel on necks.
We kneel for peace.
They kneel on necks.
We kneel for peace.
They kneel on necks.
We kneel
for peace.
They kneel
on necks.
Also, it represents what you're about. So this microphone is your voice. Use it. I'm not trying to pass it on, because you are the ones that are going to change the world. Not us. Not us. You are the generation that's going to change this world.
This activism day in and day out made me decide to utilize my own art to make my own political statement for the first time, which, by the way, if you've already seen, here are some bloopers from it.
And how much, like what?
Stop pouring.
No, not like that.
That's what I mean, you goofball, tell me.
Pour. It is.
Is it really?
Yeah.
It's
cornstarch.
What is it?
It's fake blood.
Yeah, I know, but
I even went as far as filming during the middle of the night just to get the perfect shot.
Francis Anisi, it has been way too long.
It has been.
Last time I had you on camera was about, I'd say, a year and 3 months ago.
Maybe a little bit over that. It's definitely been way too long to type.
By the way, this was actually the last video I uploaded on my channel, so if you haven't seen it yet and you're down to watch it, I'll leave a link to it right here. honestly didn't feel like America was a place worth celebrating this year. So I drove up to my favorite spot along the mountainside. And I just watched the entire sky explode.
Once a time, put a time in your ear on the beach.
What I can say is this is definitely something I'll be making into a yearly tradition. It's just something you have to see once a year, if not once in your lifetime. So I'll definitely be coming back. I just hope I have some company next time. As unfortunate as it was that the class of 2020 didn't get a proper graduation, I have to say it was something to witness how they pulled off a drive-through graduation. As I watched my little brother graduate high school, I also got the chance to see my little sister enter high school, which I was happy to be a part of as well.
Yeah. What's up, Maya? Let me see.
I'm official!
Boy! My boy! Let me see the hat!
Just when I thought the year couldn't get any crazier, Nick, out of all people, happens to get a job with Angel.
Look who it is! Yo!
A match made in hell. Me and my family had been through a lot at this point, even though it was barely halfway through the year. So we decided to take one last family trip because why the fuck not?
Can you look at him? No, look. It's Claw's name, Claw Ace.
Ace! That is so cute.
Claw Ace, he'll do it.
Your ears are so fluffy, I love them.
If you call him Ace from over there, then you can take the photo.
Hi, Ace.